We have previously seen Teslas driving astronauts in a SpaceX crew vehicle. We also heard about Cybertruck and Starships sharing same materials. But now, SpaceX intends to use a Starlink dish in their upcoming Starship SN-15 test flight. Make sure you watch until the end of the video, because today, we tell you why SpaceX may be using Starlink dish in their upcoming Starship SN-15 test flight. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. When SN-15's new antennas picture first appeared, several users in space forums and Reddit noted that a white round object in it bore a striking resemblance to a SpaceX Starlink dish. While speculations on this intensified, SpaceX submitted a new request with the Federal Communications Commission seeking to test a Starlink terminal onboard Starship during the upcoming flight test. SpaceX requested permission to operate a Starlink dish, a user terminal, in Boca Chica at altitudes not to exceed 12.5 kilometers during operations on the ground or during test flights. They intended to use it for 8 minutes in the flight highest. In other words, the antenna installed on Starship SN-15 is almost certainly a Starlink dish. Surrounded by an aerodynamic shroud, the antenna is firmly fixed on the rocket and would rely entirely upon cutting-edge phased array beam forming to electronically steer itself to both transmit and receive from one or more of almost 1,000 operational Starlink satellites currently in orbit. In the request, SpaceX curiously asked for the 60-day test period to begin on April 20th. Even if the FCC moves extremely quickly and grants the STA within a few days to a week of SpaceX's April 9th request, it's unlikely that the company would delay Starship's SN-15 test or launch plans by almost 10 days to wait for permission to use the rocket's new Starlink antenna. But the big question is, why is SpaceX putting a Starlink in a test flight of SN-15 when it is only going to rise a maximum of 12.5 kilometers? We know that rockets have to communicate telemetry data to ground station. Maybe this new Starlink dish will be used to communicate those data. But Starship already had technology built into them to communicate the telemetry data to ground station, right? It is unlikely that SpaceX will be using the Starlink as a main medium of telemetry, as it is still pending to FCC approval. So maybe SpaceX is trying to obtain telemetry redundancy by adding this new medium of data exchange. Maybe in the future flights, SpaceX wants Starlink to be a primary medium of data exchange for telemetry. This is a good test to find out how Starlink performs in that purpose. We have to remember that Starships are designed to travel to Mars, and they will be flying in the orbital. Starlink will be particularly useful in transmitting the telemetry of the orbital data, as in, the orbital communicating to Starlink satellites will be much easier than communicating to the ground tower. Why reinvent the wheel when they already have a proven method of data exchange like Starlink? These sort of cross-pollination of technology isn't anything new for Elon Musk and his companies. We have previously seen Teslas driving astronauts in the SpaceX crew vehicle that was launched by a Falcon Heavy. We heard about Cybertruck and Starships sharing the same materials. We have seen Tesla and SpaceX factories having a lot of common technology. Elon likes to cross-use technologies to solve similar problems in different industries. But sometimes Elon does these for publicity too. The news of Starship having Starlink dish in it will certainly boost the PR of Starlink. SpaceX wants airlines to use Starlink for wireless internet in the flight. The survival and growth of Starlink business is important, as it has potential to economically support SpaceX's ultimate mission of sending humanity to Mars. SpaceX needs to have 25 million subscribers in order to reach break-even, so this kind of news will help SpaceX to make Starlink more mainstream. If you like this video, you may also like to watch the video shown in this end screen on Starlink versus Kuiper. See you there!